We're talking now to former Kansas City, Missouri Police Chief Darryl Forte. He grew up in Kansas City, was here during that time of unrest. What do you remember about that day?
I remember the police with the billy clubs and the brown helmets. I was a sixth grader at Francis Willard at 50th and Garfield, and we lived at 50th and Wabash.
Weren't there one of the armored vehicles over by your grandmother's house?
Yes, on Prospect. I remember seeing that. I thought it was the Army, but as I got older, I realized it was the National Guard. I remember seeing on television that her house, store around the corner from her house was on fire. My grandmother's 95 years old, and she still stays in the same house a couple blocks off Prospect.
How did that shape you going into the police academy?
You know, I had a different vision and perception of the police department at that time. When I saw that as a six-year-old, I thought they mistreated some members of the community. And my grandmother brought up to me over and over that I talked about being a police officer in the second grade. I remember from the time of the sixth grade, but she said from the time I was in the second grade, I talked about it. So it had some influence on me, and it had some influence while I was a police officer.
How did it change policing? We've come a long way since then.
I think rather than just have town hall meetings and meetings when things were bad, the police started reaching out a little more than they did. In my opinion, we don't reach out enough, or they don't reach out enough, but they started reaching out to the community and started listening to the community more. And what I would like to continue to see is for the police to reach out when there's no conflict or little conflict or no major conflict, because that's where you build the relationships. And I think over the years, last 15 or 20 years, the former administration, before I got in there, they started building relationships with community members. And when I became chief, I made it a point not to sit in the office and be out in the field on a regular basis.
You were chief during the riots in Ferguson.
Yes.
We had a very different response in Kansas City. Is that the reason why?
I think in part, and it's not the police, and it wasn't just the politicians. It was some people like Pat Clark, and you have other people out there in the community that been doing things forever. They low profile, but they're out there doing some things, and that helped too. And I think, again, we, not just me as the police chief, we did a lot of things before the riots in Ferguson to help us.
As we go forward, do you see this kind of a shift taking place across the country? Because this has been a big problem in other cities as well.
No, I don't really see a big shift. I think oftentimes, just like here in Kansas City, not blaming anyone for it, that oftentimes we don't pay a lot of attention to it until there's a crisis. And now we want to start having town hall meetings. We have committees and things like that. I think that should be something that's ongoing. And I think people are a little more receptive when there's not a lot of high profile conflict to come to those meetings.
How do we build that kind of community going forward? I mean, it's not just the police's job.
I think just people going up to police officers, just a simple thing, going out and reaching out. If you don't think the police are reaching out to you, reach out to the police. You know, and we're just like everybody else. We have faults and flaws and everything else, but come reach out to us. Most police officers out there want to be out there. They want to be out there. I'd say 99% of them want to be out there. They want to do a good job, and they do a good job.
And we talked a little bit earlier, too, about how you can help shape the police force of the future. If you see somebody that you know would be good at this.
Absolutely. You know, oftentimes they talk about the lack of minorities on the police department and the low numbers compared to the population. If someone knows someone out there that would make a good police officer, refer them to the police department, because, you know, the police are your police. So you want somebody policing your neighborhood that you think would be a good police officer. So, again, rather than complain, contribute. You know, send somebody to the police department, contact a recruiter, you know, encourage people to apply. And that's why I became a police officer. I wanted to make a difference.
Thank you for the difference you did make.
Thank you.
For your service. Former Police Chief Darryl Forte.